Hi and welcome. In today's tutorial, we're going to see how to integrate Google Admob into Unity and make some money. Now to get started, you'll have to download the Google Mobile Ads Unity plugin. The current version is 8.5.2. So this page will have the latest version. So you can download the latest version at the time of watching this video. Click on the Unity package here. I'll leave the link in the description. So the download is complete now. Now we can go ahead to Unity. And here, right click in the project folder, go to import package, custom package, and then select the package that you have downloaded and click on open. Now, while importing, you'll have two major components. One is the external dependency manager. If you already have a Google SDK inside your Unity project, you would have already imported the external dependency manager. So if you re-import it, then there might be some clash or you won't be able to build your Unity project. So it's better to check if you already have the external dependency manager, and if you already have it, then make sure to uncheck this before importing. So this won't take much time and it will import all the files that are inside the SDK onto your Unity project. Now, once you imported the package, you should see three folders here: external dependency manager, Google Mobile Ads, and plugins. Then we need to resolve for Android dependencies, but before that you have to switch the build settings or the build platform to Android. Once you switch to Android platform, you should see this dialog box about auto resolution. This is done by the external dependency manager. Just click on enable, and the Android dependency manager will try to download any dependent package that is missing. If your resolution window is basically stuck like this, that means you're having in some error here. So you can just close the window, then go to asset, external dependency manager, Android resolver, and go to resolve. So if it says resolution succeeded and you got error in the previous step, then again go to asset, external dependency manager, Android resolver, and go to force resolve. So it says resolution failed, your application will not run, see the log for details. Let's say okay and go down. So it says your Java home could not be found. So we'll have to go to edit, preferences, external tools, and we seem to have installed all versions here. So just uncheck all of these. And then recheck them. And close this window and go to assets, external dependency manager, force resolve. Make sure you do not proceed without resolving Android dependencies. Otherwise, to the end of your game, when you're ready to build, you will have lots of errors and you might not be able to debug at that point. You can see now we have got a succeeded message. So you can press OK. Now, if you go to console log, there'll be some errors. So you can just clear them. This iOS resolver error will be there if you don't have iOS module installed with Unity Editor. You can ignore this error. This won't cause any further problems while building the game. Now, if you go to the assets menu, you will have an option of Google Mobile Ads, and you can go to settings, and under settings, you will have an option for app ID and optimization options. So this app ID needs to be created. You will have to do it on Google Admob website. So just go to Google Admob. Now under Google Admob, just go to apps and click on add app. So you have to create a new app here. So based on your platform, select Android or iOS. And once that is selected, you have to select whether your app is already registered on App Store. If so, you can just select it and paste the App Store link. And in our case, we'll just select no. So let's click on continue. Now we can just give a name for this. We'll say test app and we'll click on add app. So once the app is added, just click on done. Now we have a test app here. And if you go to app settings here, you will see the app ID. You can just copy this from here, the app ID, and go to Unity, and under the settings of Google Mobile Ads, just paste it under Android. So if you're also planning to build for iOS, then you'll have to create another app in Google Admob and get the app ID of that and paste it here. Now these settings are useful if you're getting crashes and ANRs because of Google Admob SDKs. So if you're getting crashes or ANRs, you can just check these two: optimize initialization and optimize ad loading. And then you can just close this. So now your setup for Google Admob is ready. Now we'll see how to create an ad unit and then display that in our game. So go back to Google Admob, and here under add units, you have to create a new add unit. Click on get started and then select the type of ad that you want to create. So we'll be creating a banner ad. So let's select banner ad. Then we can just say test banner ad. If you're using any type of mediation, then you can just select this. Otherwise, just click on create ad unit. Make sure to remember that the app ID and the ad unit ID are two different things. Many people confuse this. The app ID is entered only in the Google Admob settings, and you will not be using that in your scripts. But the ad unit ID will be used in your scripts. Now that we have created the ad unit in the Admob website, now we have to do two things inside Unity. One is to initialize Admob. The second is to show your ad unit. The script is already available on Linux Studio. I'll leave the link in description so you can copy it. So the script is divided into two parts. One is to initialize. The other is to show the ad unit ID. Create an empty game object. Let's call it as ad manager. Now let's add a script called add script to this. And let's open it in Visual Studio for editing. Generally, the initialization of ads is done on the first scene of the game. So if you have a logo scene, you can put the initialization under the awake of that particular scene. So all you need namespace called using Google Mobile Ads.api. And then you can just call this statement under the awake of the first scene. Now to display your ad, you need to create a parameter of the ad type that you're going to show. So we are going to show a banner ad. So it's going to be banner view. So you can, as you can see, there will be more like interstitial ad. So you can see interstitial ad here. And if you want to show a rewarded ad, then you can also show rewarded ad here. So depending on what ad you want to show, you can just create a variable of that type. So here it is banner view. Now under the awake, before you show your ad, you have to check if it is Android. Then you set the app ad unit ID. Make sure you do not give the app ID here. It is the ad unit ID. And if you're doing it for iOS, check whether this is iOS and change the ad unit ID based on your iOS ad unit ID. Then you will have to initialize the banner view object of the banner view class by using new banner view, the ad unit ID, the ad size, and the ad position. So irrespective of what you've selected in Admob website, you can change the position here using this ad position attribute. And then in order to show the ad, you just have to create an ad request. You can give any variable name you want, and it will be new ad request. And once you created the request, then you can just say banner view dot load ad request. Now this will by default show the ad. So if you want to hide the ad, you can just say banner view dot hide. And if you again want to show the ad, then you can just say banner view dot show as shown in the autocomplete. So now you can just save the script and go back to Unity. Now if you play our game, you should be able to see a small banner in the Unity editor. Now we'll go into some other issues, like when you, after building your game, sometimes your app will start crashing. Now if that is happening, the major reason for that is under assets, Google Admob settings, you might have given the wrong Android app ID. So make sure this app ID is right and you have not given the ad unit ID in this place. And similarly in the script, make sure you're given the ad unit ID there and not the app ID. The second thing is your ad is not showing and your app is working fine. There might be a few reasons for this. One is if you've created a new Admob account, then it will take up to 48 hours for Google to show ads on it. And sometimes if you have a child-based app or a child-based game, then there might not be enough ads to show on your screen. Whenever you're testing, make sure you set up your device as a test device. So for that, just go to Admob and here under settings, under test device, you will have an option to add a test device. Just add your device and add the advertising ID for that. You can find the advertising ID under your phone settings. So just go ahead and search for that. So most probably if you're testing with your own device and you're clicking on ads, then you might face some kind of a ban because it's against Google policy to test on actual ads. So you'll have to set up a test device and then do the testing based on that. So that's it. This is how you can show ads on your Android game. And if you have any issues or if you have any problems, you can leave them in the comment box below and we'll try to address them. Thank you and see you in the next tutorial.